Hello, so this is just a quick tutorial about Padlet. This is a format or a platform that teachers might be using to help promote collaboration within their classroom when we're going through this period of virtual or distance learning. And so what you see here are all different layouts that a student might find when they click on a link that's provided by their teacher. For the different assignments that they're doing. So you can see that there's a variety. It really is dependent upon what the teacher is wanting to do with the information. But what all of them do are helping to promote collaboration so that the students can carry on a conversation virtually as opposed to when they're in the classroom. So it gives us an alternative format to continue that method of communication. And usually they're easy, they're fun to work with, and they're very colorful. So why would a teacher be using any one of these? Well, again, for that team building format when we're not in the classroom to help students interact with one another. They could use it as a pre-learning activity where perhaps maybe a teacher is holding a virtual face-to-face session and they want students to pre-read and respond to a couple prompts so that the teacher has an idea of maybe what kind of questions or misconceptions to be able to reflect upon with them during their conversation. It could be used for just a virtual share where students and teachers alike are adding things to just a wall. You can use it for analysis or a lot of times, many times for reflection, where you're asked to do an activity and then reflect on it in more of a community type format. So I'm gonna show you a couple of ways that I use it in my classroom. I teach anatomy and honors biology. And so in my classwork stream, what I've chosen to do is I've embedded the links for Padlets in slides that I've attached to different assignments for the students. Some teachers may just have a link that they have there that the students click on that takes them directly to the Padlet. Once the students click on this slide presentation, they would open it up and they would see something like this. In this particular example, I had them read an article and then they were to click here to access a Padlet that used a visible thinking routine to analyze the different points that were in the article. So this is the Padlet. I chose to use a shelf format and I put the questions at the top and then students have responded underneath. I've given the students at this point an option to either identify themselves or not. This student chose to remain anonymous, which is fine. And I've been responding to them so I can add my comment and your student can also would also see something at the bottom if the teacher is allowed for comments to be given to each one of the different points that others are making. You'll notice that these plus signs are underneath each column. That allows a student to be able to add their response. Now I've asked them to write their response, which they are all doing, but if I were to click on this plus sign, you'll notice that this would pop up and if I was asking for names, they would put their names in the title and then they would write something. But there's other ways that they can respond. They can upload, depending again on what the teacher is asking for, they can upload a file from their own personal drive. They can add a link. They can search for something on the web. They can take a picture. They can start their camera on their computers. If you click on these three dots, you'll notice that those four are the first four that are up here, but then you can see another of a variety of different ways that the students can respond. Teachers might give choices or they might ask for a specific type of response depending on the assignment. Here's another example of a shelf format where I asked them to reflect on an article that was talking about how tough times can create better neighbors. And so you can see that the students picked various phrases, sentences, and words that were meaningful to them. And then here's another example where this is a wall format. So what I'm having the students do is they are going to be searching for positive stories of people that are being creative and critical thinkers to think a little bit outside of the box during this time to, you know, make sure that either there's a better way for them to do something or perhaps maybe their business to thrive and stay afloat while we're going through our current situation. You can see that I'm the only one that's posted something at this point. I haven't asked my students to complete this assignment yet. It's coming up in their future assignments. And that's a little bit about Padlet.